special information available to only a few. The New York Times wrote the 21st under the headline, quote, banned techniques yielded high-value information, memo says. That's a story in the New York Times which basically recounts what the Director of National Intelligence said. So I would remind my distinguished colleague from Illinois that it is in fact the Director of National Intelligence for President Obama who has affirmed not just the need but the usefulness of the information and intelligence derived from these enhanced interrogation techniques that were approved by the legal authority for the executive branch of the federal government, the Office of Legal Counsel. My colleague from Illinois, Senator Durbin, argues that we need to allow prosecutors to follow the facts and the law wherever they may lead. Certainly a relatively harmless and assertion, one I would generally agree with. But here, Mr. President, we know enough about the facts and the law to know that there is no evidence that anyone acted with the intent required to prosecute under the law. And I won't bore the Senate with an analysis of what the criminal law requires under this in this context, but I would say that the facts as we know them are enough to give our public servants the benefit of the doubt. As detailed in the Office of Legal Counsel Memoranda, significant efforts were made to minimize significant harm that could arise from these techniques. And who could question the desire of both the intelligence community as well as the Department of Justice and the leaders responsible for protecting our national security? Who could question their good faith, the good faith need to get information that would actually help prevent follow-on terrorist attacks? We know that Al-Qaeda on September the 11th, 2001, used crude weapons to attack our country and yet were able to kill 3,000 Americans, roughly. Our intelligence community and our national leadership knew that Al-Qaeda was not satisfied with such primitive weapons, but indeed was seeking biological, chemical, or nuclear weapons. And so we know how important it was for our intelligence officials to get the information they needed. We know that the lawyers at the Office of Legal Counsel who rendered this legal advice were doing what they thought was their responsibility in good faith. And indeed, the members of Congress that had the responsibility to perform congressional oversight on these activities, I believe, demonstrated their good faith desire to do what was necessary to protect our country. So I believe we know enough to say that these people, all of them, acted in good faith. It's been suggested that the standard we apply is whether the advice fell within the range of legitimate legal analysis and the range of reasonable disagreement common to legal analysis of important statutory and constitutional questions. And I believe that that's been demonstrated here. And but for this technical objection to the amendment, I'm confident we would receive an overwhelming bipartisan vote of support for this Sense of the Senate resolution. The distinguished senator from Illinois, Senator Durbin, says that we should allow prosecutors in the Department of Justice whether to bring a case against these officials, the intelligence community, the lawyers who drafted the legal advice, and perhaps even the members of Congress that acquiesced and facilitated these enhanced interrogation techniques following a classified briefing. But I would suggest, Mr. President, there is no case to be brought against these individuals. Any prosecution that arises out of this interrogation program would clearly be based upon politics and not on the law. So I would submit that the amendment that I've offered, that I've just described, and which I will reoffer again at an appropriate time, is a call for reasonableness and national unity. The calls for prosecution of good faith patriots has simply gone too far. And when bloggers and others, not to just single out bloggers, but even members of this body have suggested that we somehow need a truth commission and have suggested that prosecutions might be the appropriate outcome. When they're suggesting that prosecutions under these circumstances occur, then I think our political environment has changed in a dangerous way, and one which our intelligence officials and gathering actionable intelligence necessary to keep us safe and certainly discourage patriots who want to serve and who are willing to serve in government. When policy differences become criminalized in ways that some have suggested here, it is not helpful to our country. Indeed, I think it's dangerous to our national security. We know that there's an unfortunate history of hysterias, panics, and mob rule from time to time that occurs, whether it's from Salem through the McCarthy era. But justice is steered, when justice is steered by passion and politics rather than by reason and the rule of law, it is not worthy of the name justice. Once you stir up an angry mob, we know that it's unpredictable where that mob might lead or who might get caught up in the mob's action. But we know here already too many patriotic Americans have been targeted by the present hysteria. So this amendment calls for an end to the hysteria and a return to reason, civility, national unity, and the rule of law. Mr. President, I am going to turn to another subject, but may I inquire how much time is remaining under the unanimous consent agreement?